our lunch. Anem a començar amb la part final de la conferència. Ara farem la taula rodona amb els experts. Està previst que duri com a màxim una hora i després obrirem un torn de, li hem dit, diàleg obert, perquè no cal que siguin preguntes. Si teniu o voleu fer qualsevol aportació de tot el que s'hagi dit durant la jornada o expressar qualsevol opinió, o també, evidentment, si voleu fer alguna pregunta sobre el projecte o sobre qualsevol aspecte relacionat amb el bullying, doncs, evidentment, esteu convidats a fer-ho un cop acabem la taula rodona. La taula rodona està basada en un guió de preguntes que farà la Dúnia i bueno, anirem fent contribucions a les preguntes en funció de la nostra experiència de manera espontània, intentarem que sigui el més àgil possible. D'acord? Abans de començar us presento a la Maria Markela de Elino Germaniki, Agogi from Greece, Maria from the Smile of the Child, Rosi de Nadia Foundation, Bulgaria, Alexandra de Association for Equal Opportunities, SEMPER, de Macedònia del Nord, i Alina de Associació Direct de Romania. Bueno, jo sóc el Ferran de l'Associació Roma. Li cedeixo la paraula a la Dúnia. Gràcies.
Bueno, el Ferran ja us ha explicat més o menys la idea de la taula rodona. Jo ara us faré una sèrie de preguntes perquè em parli una mica de les seves experiències i després, doncs, com bé ha dit el Ferran, us direm si tenim dubtes, opinions, jo què sé. Voleu fer comentaris, tenir curiositat, d'acord? So, shall we go for it? Let's start. I would like you to share with us how is your experience and your involvement against bullying before the Repay project, and why did you decide to take part on the Repay project?
Thanks for the questions, but actually most of the partners, maybe three of them, we know each other since a lot of years. And when the leading partners, the Smile of the Child in Greece, invite us, and we are working with them more than 10 years in different projects, in different programs, bringing almost the same very important, like Hotline for Children, for Missing Children in our countries, bordering in Greece and in Bulgaria. For us, it's really an honor to be part of the next idea of our colleagues. With Ferran and Baobab, we also know maybe more than 6-7 years. We had a wonderful different project, especially on empowering women for a lot of years, if I'm correct. And we are really happy when they share with us this idea, especially working with children, especially working on the anti-bullying activities. For us, like partners, let's mention also our colleague from Romania, Direct Association. We also was all of us partners in a ABC anti-bullying project before several years, and after that, together with the again leading role of the Smile of the Child, we established the European Anti-Bullying Network. So our partners, we are really, really great to hear that it's possible to work on the anti-bullying issue at all. That's why I'm really happy to be part of this project. And honestly, speaking in comparison with a lot of other projects, maybe this is Erasmus Plus is a really good platform for exchanging the not only visit and ideas, but very, very hard work. During these 2.5 years, I think, we did a ideas, how is the most proper way to to say to really follow the best and to select the programs and the materials. And actually, you have to thanks a lot for the paper community, right? Because they are specifically dedicated to this part of the project and excellent results. A lot of products, it's not like industrial products, but intellectual, really, really intellectual. All of us. So I'm really happy and see how to continue in this direction altogether.
Association Direct has been involved for many years in this subject. For instance, Joanna's doctoral studies subject was anti-bullying, so she has started a long time before, and if you check on our site, you will see that almost all of our projects are targeted at this subject. The most important part and the most interesting thing is that this project is one of the very few that can give us a tool, a toolbox for working in schools. And let's admit that bullying is has been a very old subject that has been just in the 70s years by Dan Olveus was admitted to be bullying, and people do not know how to cope in the school. How to cope in the classroom is very difficult, and maybe this is the first project for us when we could get a lot of materials and implement in our schools. I think this is the best thing. So congratulations.
No one else?
From the Smile of the Tribe, it's an NGO addressing to abused children, first of all. And we have a department which is called Department of Awareness and Sensitization, addressing to children, teachers and parents and guardians. And one of the subjects that we go to classrooms and teachers and parents and talk about it is bullying and what is it and how we can deal with it. So one thing that has been missing is the need of teachers to have a tool in the classroom which is with specific steps of what we can do when we have something that we have to deal with it regarding bullying, but also how can we prepare the children even before having a bullying incident, to recognize it, how to deal with it. So this program, PREPI, has a specific tool for teachers which is very helpful, and the videos I think are also very helpful. And the fact that the children can be creative and work together and cooperate and feel like a team all together and feel responsible to take action and recognize what bullying is and how we can deal with it. And I would like to say that we are also a founding member of European Anti-Bullying Network, and we have the presidency of EAN. And bullying is one of, it's a major subject for every country, not only for Europe. And school dropout is something that makes us think, how can we help the students, the school, the parents find a solution.
Hello, from me as well. My personal experience with anti-bullying activities is not very long. However, in the Γερμανική school, the school I teach, we think it's very important to empower the children and make them understand how they can deal with bullying and what they can do to prevent it and stop it, not only to themselves, but when they see it happening around them. So